previous two modules, we looked at the contextual hindrances and the industry challenges facing African cities. In this module, we want to look at the bright side and untapped potentials and opportunities residing in African cities. So, according to Udeze, even though the current circumstances would otherwise, the inevitable outcome of rapid urbanization in Africa does not have to be a profound number of unemployed citizens in need of low-income houses in the absence of any, and therefore facing a housing shortage and turning to the informal sector for survival and ending up in slums and squatter settlements. So according to the group model proposed by Onyema in 2011, the following are some potential benefits that could be reaped from the rapid urbanization in African cities. Firstly, rapid urbanization will help inject a fresh labor force into the economy, allowing for the division of labor and specialization, and thus enabling economies of scale to result. This in turn will promote innovation and economic growth. Then secondly, the increase in demand for housing as a result of the rapid urbanization can stimulate the construction boom, which will result in enabling the benefits of backward and forward linkages in the forms of increased income as well as employment in the country. Moreover, the resulting increase in the supply of housing will lower the price of houses and would help attract skilled labor and investment prospects into the country. Thirdly, the growth of the construction sector will avail those dependent on the informal sector better living as well as employment options, therefore reducing the informal sector. And fourthly, the government will be able to collect increased tax revenue from the decline in the informal sector, as the revenue gained from employment in this sector is never truly accounted for, and thus does not contribute to the gross national product of the economy. And finally, another untapped potential is that the use of local goods and natural resources by the housing sector as opposed to lavish imports will help play a great role in directing the capital spending into producing greater domestic multiplier. So I believe that for this moment, we realize that there are still some hopes as regards housing provision in African cities. In the next module, we'll look at some other aspects of the African housing menace. Stay tuned.